If you're someone who is wondering what it is that your spirit guides want you to know, and we have many of them as we go throughout our life and we go through different levels and stages of growth and aging, we have different guides that come in to help us out. In this video here, I'm going to share with you some basic, well, I'm going to give you 6 different things that they really want you to know and understand, not only so you can help prepare and start working with them, but what you can expect when you make that connection with them. So if that sounds super cool to you, do me a favor, hit that thumbs up button right now. We'll consider that a virtual high five between the two of us. Oh boy, hang out to the end because I got some freaking bloopers for you. This is what happens when you don't follow a script and try and pull a video out of your freaking ass without putting it together on paper and organizing it. So if you're brand spanking new here and you have no idea who I am, give me a quick second and let me introduce myself. My name's Judy Jameson and I'm a psychic. I teach intuition and psychic development, but with a little bit of a twist to it. I work with empaths who are going through some kind of trauma, life transition, or spiritual awakening. By learning what your natural intuitive and psychic gifts are, learning how to work with your spirit guides, you have like a secret tool, genie in a bottle, blessing at your beck and freaking call all the time to help you heal, help you power up, help bring abundance into your life, help show you all the yellow road, the yellow brick roads, right? Am I saying that right? If you're an empath and you want to learn how to power the hell up and become super freaking strong, that empowered empath who not only repels toxic people and life's bullshit, but wants to attract to you all forms of abundance, I am your new virtual best friend, and you're going to want to hit the subscribe button that's right underneath this video. If you're not already a subscriber, I'm going to give you a second to do that right now. Make sure you hang out till the end of the video because I have a freebie for you that will really help open up and enhance your natural intuitive and psychic abilities. All right, so you ready? Let's get this party started. 6 different things that your spirit guides want you to know. So if you're kind of curious, you're a little freaked out, a little scared of working with them, you don't know what to expect or how this kind of stuff works, this video is going to help you out. So the first thing that they want you to know is you are a spiritual, energetic being, right? Just living a physical, worldly experience. So what exactly does this mean? You agreed to come down here into a physical body, being born, and experience a wide freaking range of highs and freaking lows and crap stories and high happiness intensity, all kinds of emotional roller coaster, confusing freaking chaos crap. The reason why you agreed to do this kind of stuff is so that you can expand your soul and remember who the fuck you are on an energetic level, not what worldly logic and reason will tell you. You are here to remember and discover your passions and your purpose. Think of it this way. I look at Earth as like college, right? When you're up here writing out your script of your life purpose and your passions and things that you want to experience so as a soul you can evolve and grow, you come down here to Earth to experience all that shit. When you come down here, your brain is kind of, I don't want to say erased, but your memory is gone as to all your past life experiences that are leading you to this current particular life and journey that you're living. You're here to learn, okay? Your spirit guides are there to help guide you as you go through this journey process that should be starting here and going all kinds of this way up to here, not starting down here and going downwards. When you learn how to work with your spirit guides, you start to remember who you are on a very deep, personal, intimate soul level. The second thing that they want you to know is that you are never alone. The same way that you have a physical family here, your mom, your dad, your siblings, aunts and uncles, cousins, whatever, in the energetic spirit world, you have an entire freaking family. But this family is like different and super freaking cool. The energetic family, they know you better than you know yourself. They don't judge you. They totally get everything that you do, everything that you think, everything that you feel, and they unconditionally love you, right? That's a big one. Sometimes we go through our physical world and family members want certain things from us or do certain things to us. Your spirit guides aren't like that. Your spirit guides are here to help you. All you got to do is ask them and invite them to come in. So when you feel like the physical world and the people that are around you in your life just ain't freaking cutting it, you're not alone. You have an entire energetic family on the other side. Although I say the other side, they're not really on the other side, but they're everywhere all around you. So when life is kicking your ass and you're not getting the support that you need from family or friends or just life in general, you're not alone. Just tune into your freaking guides. 3, they are always constantly trying to connect with you. So if you're that person who's constantly like, just show me a sign or give me a sign or I'm not getting signs, I guarantee you're getting 100 freaking signs a day. You're just not tuned into it, so you're missing them. So how do they try and connect with you? Through signs, synchronicities, meditation, dreams, aha moments, you channeling your inner creativity. There's so many freaking ways that they try and come into your life and speak to you. They will connect to you through what your personal strengths are, what your desires are, what your passions are, when you're at that ultimate high vibrational state. So to give you an example, if you're someone who's a bird watcher and you love birds, guess what? Your spirit guides are going to try and connect to you through birds or bird watching. If you're someone who loves being outside, outdoors, doing nature type things, guess what? Your guides are going to try and communicate with you through nature. If you're a DIY creative type person, guess what? They'll try and connect with you through the arts, okay? You don't need to do any kind of weird woo-woo, anything like that. As long as you're connected to your passions or the things that make you happy, the things that really bring you to life, that's how they're gonna come in and try and give you signs. 4, they want you to know that you call the shots in your life, not them, okay? A lot of times people think when you channel in information, something comes into your body and takes over. No, it doesn't work like that. We have this wonderful thing called free will. They don't control you, they guide you. You choose whether or not you're gonna listen to it. They come in and step out whenever you ask them to. The key concept here with trying to channel in your guides is understanding that it is your life. You hold the pen to it. You control in the physical world who comes in and who goes, who you attract and who you repel, whose crap you put up with and whose crap you don't. Your spirit guides aren't like that. They're not expecting or demanding anything from you. They're just patiently sitting there waiting for you to invite them in so they can give you guidance. They're not gonna slap you upside the head like the freaking physical world will. 5, I can't tell you how many freaking readings I do on this kind of stuff. They constantly ask for you to stop taking yourself out of the greatness that you were born to experience. You get to choose whether this physical experience that you're living is heaven on earth or freaking hell on earth. When we get wrapped up in worldly logic and reasons and thought processes and stuff like that, you start living what feels like hell on earth. We live in this physical world based on if you can't see it, hear it, taste it, touch it, smell it, then it ain't real, right? But I tell you what, your dreams, your desires, the things that you feel called to do, they are your spirit guides trying to guide you to remember your soul, your purpose, your passion, why it is that you're here. That is like your energetic blueprint on the kind of life that you're supposed to be living, not what society or your parents tell you to do. Problem is here, when you were born into this physical body, you came with this thing called an ego. The ego is that little devil nagging on your shoulder, right, that controls you through fear. Fear of failure, fear of looking like an idiot, fear that nobody's gonna love you, whatever the freak the fear is, fear of not having enough money. Your guides want you to stop focusing on the fears and start energetically feeling and focusing on, what if this really does come true and happen? So stop squashing your dreams and your desires, those little butterflies and callings and desires of things that you want to live. The 6th thing that they want you to know, they can't help you if you don't know what the hell you want. Basically, what that means is if you're living your life on autopilot, which is basically survival mode, right? You wake up, you go to work, you take care of the kids, rinse, rinse, wash, repeat, rinse, wash, repeat, right? It's autopilot. It's surviving life. That's not living life. You are here to live and enjoy and expand and experience every wonderful thing that life has to offer. Instead, we get sucked into the worldly crap, the bullshit, the to-do list, the responsibilities, the other people's crap, you freaking name it. You have to get very clear on what it is that you want, the kind of life that you want, the way that you want to feel. Once you're clear on that and you're truly vibing with it and believing it and knowing it's possible, you just then raise your vibration and then it makes it easier for your guides to come in and communicate with you. So I got a question for you before I tell you about this freebie. The whole reason why I make these videos is to make them interactive. The only way that's going to happen is if you comment below, and I do get notifications when people comment and I do reply back. So I got a question for you. Comment below and tell me what silly ego BS excuse are you telling yourself that is hindering you from your desires, that is preventing you from discovering your passions and your purpose? What BS excuse are you telling yourself that is blocking you from becoming the most magical, magnificent, energetic freaking being living heaven on earth? And if you kind of already know what it is that you want and what it is that you desire, what kind of life that you want to live, how you want to feel, comment below and share with me. What are your passions and what are your purposes? And if you've gotten messages from your guides as to the next steps, share them with me. All right, so remember I told you I had a freebie for you. I actually got two of them. The first one is 30 different ways that you can tune into, tap, open up, and expand your natural intuitive and psychic gifts so you can start working with your guides and getting those downloads and getting those messages. The second freebie I have for you is cord cutting. When you're working with your intuition and your psychic senses, cord cutting and shadow work is huge. I do it on a daily basis. The whole point of cord cutting is figuring out what those limiting beliefs are, what your fears are, what is preventing you from achieving your goals and your desires and your dreams. When you get in the process of cord cutting, you're releasing all that crap and ditching it so you're nice and open to receive abundance. The other thing I have for you, it's not a freebie though, but if you want to fast pass and skip right to the freaking front of the line right here and now and start learning how to remove all blocks to abundance, how to discover your passion, your purpose, why it is that you're here, if you want to learn how to remove every single limiting block to clear yourself out so you're a nice clear conduit and vessel to not only connect with yourself, but open yourself up to channel information from your guides, there's an online course I have called Open Your Intuition and Your Psychic Senses. This is a full-blown 22 video lesson course that you get like Netflix and chill. You get it, you get all the content, you sit back and watch it and go through the exercises whenever the hell you feel like it. So if you want to check that out, that link is also underneath this video. All right, that's what I got for you. I hope you have a wonderful, phenomenal, kick freaking ass, high vibrational day. Hopefully you hit that subscribe button, comment below, talk to me. Let's make this an interactive dialogue. Hopefully I'll see you real soon right here on this channel. See you later. If you're here and you're watching this, fuck. If you're here and you're wondering what, fuck. Your life, fuck, take that out. So if you're trying to connect and you're, fuck. The whole reason why, anyway, I lost freaking track of what the hell I was saying. I don't even freaking know.